You know, life is full of unexpected things. It's amazing how all of a sudden you can go from being calm and being in your life and being stable and everything seems to be fine, and then all of a sudden the next second something happens, or you get a phone call, or you see an airplane on the TV, and the entire world just changes at that moment. Your emotions and your life and everything that you are seems to stop. And I don't know where you were on that day, but I was in my living room. My husband had an interview that morning. I watched the replay of the first plane, and then I watched live as the second plane went in, and it impacted our lives, and it changed us forever. Even today, in our own little corner of the world, the fires are burning, and people are running from their homes, leaving everything they have behind, and wondering if they'll have anything to go back to, wondering if their pictures from their weddings or things that were important and special to them, or maybe their animals were alive. I watched a picture, saw a picture on Facebook that a guy was riding his horse down the median with two horses behind him, escaping the flames, trying to keep his animals alive. And I'm wondering what's going through his mind as he runs away from this danger that's in front of him. We all suffer. We all have these emotional responses that are so strong, that are so immense, that are almost a physical emotional response, not just something that's quiet, but something that engulfs you at some times in your life. Last October, I got a phone call, and I found out that my mother had cancer. I was alone in a car, in a parking lot, fixing to get gas in my car, and there were so many turmoils going on in my life at that time, I didn't need one more. Definitely not that my mom had cancer. And I cried, and I feared that I was going to lose my mom. And in that moment, it just seemed so alone and so desperate and so full of emptiness almost. And yet, I knew I had God. When I gathered with my family, we all gathered together and we prayed. And then we literally held hands, my mom, my sister, my dad. And we walked into the cancer treatment room because we began to battle something that had a name. We were battling cancer, and we were going to fight. And as we walked into that room holding hands together, we were afraid. But we walked together with Jesus, knowing that he was walking into that room. We were there for a few hours. The mom had to be there all day. And Dad left to go to lunch. And as he went down the elevator, he met a woman who, ironically, her husband was in very similar shoes, but he was in much worse condition. It was his first day having chemo also. And through the relationship that developed from my mom and my dad meeting these two folks, at the last moment, really not very long before he passed, he realized that God was God and that he needed him. And it was amazing to watch this transformation, a desperate cry in a moment where he actually gave his life to Christ. And he's there because my mom and dad had an opportunity to be vessels for God, an opportunity that even in the struggle and even in the pain and even in this terrible thing called cancer, that yet he could use them to be able to help and to win one more soul, and to bring one more person to him. Fast forward a few months, and actually just about a month ago, my mom was in the hospital again, still fighting cancer. She couldn't breathe. She was coughing. She couldn't walk 5 feet without assistance because she was having so much problems, and we were all so afraid. You know, the nurse came in, and she was from a foreign country, and that always makes you nervous because you just don't know how well you're going to be able to communicate. And she said her name, and we couldn't pronounce it. And then she said, "It's okay. In English, my name means peace. So just call me Peace." And the shift changed, and the new nurse walked in, and she said, "My name is Faith. I just want to write it down on the board so that you remember who I am." They had a little chalkboard in the room. I'm like, "Wow, what's next?" And then joy walked in the room. And it was amazing to see what God did. First, my mom needed peace. And then my mom needed faith in the battle. And then we needed to know that joy, even amongst the battle that we were facing, and that how every moment he was there, but we had to look for him, you see. If we had faced and looked at the needle they were bringing in, or looked at the oxygen they were bringing in, or looked at the different pieces that they were bringing in, we would have looked at the problem and not the source of the solution, and not the source of the love and the mercy and the grace that was surrounding us. You know, we all have things like this. Mom still has cancer, but Mom has Jesus. And that's all we really need. song. It's called Blessings. And she poses questions like,